Hello and welcome to the Gray Room. Recently I had a friend come in from out of town, and whenever he came over he said, "Hey, I've got something I want to give you. I've had it for a while and it's been sitting in my garage waiting for you." And when he pulled it out, it was the Star Wars Galactic Battle. And basically what that is, it's the Electronic Battleship with the Star Wars motif. So, let's check it out. Okay, here it is. The Star Wars Electronic Galactic Battle. And over here we see it says, "Real Voices and Sounds from the Star Wars Trilogy." Here's a picture of the game, and like I said before, it's like Electronic Battleship, only with the Star Wars motif. Down here at the bottom of the box, it shows the 10 different ships that it comes with, 5 from the Rebel side and 5 from the Imperial side. So let's take this out of the box and check it out. Okay, when we pull it out of the box, here's what we find. We have the two-piece electronic game board, and this top piece snaps in pretty easily just like that. And we have the instruction booklet. We have the Rebel ships and bases. We have the Imperial ships and bases. And then we have the hit and miss pegs. So, let's put this together and take a look at the game. Here's the game board all set up. You got the Rebels on one side and the Imperial fleet on the other. And when you turn it on, here's what it sounds like.
Ready, Rebel Commander. Ready, Imperial Commander. May the Force be with you.
Alright, so that's what it sounds like when you start it up. And the ships that it comes with are, from biggest to smallest, we have the, on the Rebel side, we have the Star Cruiser, the Rebel Transport, the Y-Wing, the X-Wing, and the A-Wing. Then on the Imperial side, we have the Imperial Star Destroyer, the Victory Star Destroyer, the TIE Bomber, the TIE Interceptor, and then the TIE Fighter. So that's what the game board looks like when you set it up. I'll program it here and I'll show you what a hit and a miss sounds like. So each grid point has a number to it, and whenever you're going to pick that number, you enter it in, and then you hit fire.
Imperial Star Destroyer, hit. Imperial Commander, select targets, fire.
So that was the sound of a hit, and this is the sound of a miss. You just hear
Rebel
the
Commander, select targets, fire.
You just hear the lasers and there's no explosion afterward. So aside from the laser sounds and the explosion sounds, there's also quotes from the movie, like, "It's a trap," and "You got one on your tail," and "I can't shake him," things like that throughout the game as you're shooting and hitting and missing, things like that. And then there's also 3 levels of the game. There's the standard where you just, each person takes one shot at each other back and forth in turns. Then the second level, you can shoot, like whenever you would start out shooting 5 times first, and then however many ships you have left as the game goes on, that's how many shots you take on your turn. Then the third level of the game has that where you take how many shots of ships you have left on each turn. Plus, during the game you get to launch additional ships throughout the game as you play it. So there's actually several more ships that you can add on throughout the game. Here's a close-up of the game board, and the way it's set up is in a hexagonal grid pattern, so that each grid point is on a hexagon, and what that does is it puts each grid point at a slight angle. But the only thing with that is that you cannot put a ship horizontal on the game board. It doesn't fit, and there would be no grid point for the center of the ship. So you can only do them at diagonals or verticals on the game board. So I think, in my opinion, that takes away from a little bit of the strategic positioning of your ships. The other thing is that the ships are small. As you can see, the larger ships aren't even as long as the bases, and this goes for the 3, 4, and 5 peg ships. The 2 peg ships, I think, are about the right size But it's the same thing for the Rebel and the Imperial ships. I mean, here's a look at the Imperial Star Destroyer, which is the huge ship that we see at the beginning of the Star Wars movie, and it's not as long as the base. That ship should be huge. Another thing that I think could be better about the game board is that the places where you put your hit and your miss pegs are not square, and they're very small, as you can see with my hand. So it's really hard to get the pegs out when you're playing the game. So what we did is we just set the pegs on the table while we were playing, and we didn't use the spots. One of the other features that this game has is that you can manually enter the grid points of your ship locations by entering in the starting grid point and the ending grid point of your ship into the computer, and then it automatically knows the size of the ship and what points are in between. The other way you can do it is choosing from the instruction booklet one of the pre-programmed grid sets for the ship locations. And there's 100 of them in the back of the book, so there's quite a few. And then it comes with a number for the grid set, and then you program that number in, and then it knows where the ships are on the game board. Overall, I think it's a pretty cool game. It definitely has some cool sound effects and the movie quotes. Plus, you get the miniatures of the different ships from the Star Wars movies. I've had a good time playing it, and I definitely look forward to playing a lot more. I hope you guys have enjoyed the review of it. And if you've had a chance to play the game, let me know with a comment or a video response what you thought of it.